To-do list applications, there are more and more being added every single day, and it is a growing set of tools that can help you to be more productive and balance your day ahead. But there are new applications making waves all the time, and we love to cover them here on Keep Productive because it gives us a direction where to-do list applications are heading in the future. We did it recently with note-taking applications, and today we're doing it with to-do list applications. So these are five new to-do list applications that are making waves in the productivity space. Welcome, my name is Francesco. Very excited to dive into this lot for you. This video today is brought to you by Toolfinder. You'll find Toolfinder linked below, and it is something that we've created to help you find the best productivity tool. We've got a brand new newsletter as well, which goes out twice a month, covering all of the latest productivity guides, resources, and news for you to keep updated. So let's dig a little bit deeper into these to-do list applications. And I'm gonna be diving into them in a little bit of detail, but I'll be linking all of the accounts below if you want to go a little bit further. But the first on our list is actually one that is fairly new to me. And I discovered it because it kept cropping up quite routinely. And it's BeforeSunset. And it's sort of like a lighter weight version of the likes of Sun Sama, trying to help you focus on more mindful productivity to some extent with your task management. Now, BeforeSunset is pretty simple in its nature. It allows you to add tasks, be able to assign a duration to them, and be able to plot them in a calendar that lives alongside your task list. But there are a few nice things about this. You can utilize AI inside of this to be able to plan your day for you. This is becoming much more popular in applications like Motion and many more that are trying to take advantage of artificial intelligence to reorganize and better suit your day. Now, as you can imagine, it's not fully ready yet in terms of its ability. AI is evolving and understanding what actually tasks mean, but this is a really interesting example of a more mindful productivity tool that helps you do that. And what it does is it plots all of those tasks on a calendar for you and allows you to sync with the likes of Google Calendar. And at the bottom, which I find particularly interesting, is you've got a view of your day and a really nice view because you can see the sun rise and set and allows you to shut down your day, much like Sun Sama does, and also allows you to start a break, which is something that other productivity applications really do ignore sometimes. This application reminds me of an older app called Friday, which was out for some time, but naturally shut down last year, I believe. And it is a shame, but this application is a more condensed version of Friday, and it seems like a really interesting to-do list application that's on the market right now. It does have a pretty steep pro plan, to be honest, and a lot of that is unlimited AI tech and analytics. The analytics themselves give you insight into your week. After a few weeks of using BeforeSunset, you basically get to see a window into where you spend your time, where you spend your energy levels, and how long you spend it, which is quite an interesting perspective. So next up is one called Superlist, and this is actually from the creators of Wunderlist, which was a productivity application, a to-do list app that was launched a fair few years ago now. Well, the founders and the team are pretty much back to take the new experience to the next level for tasks. And although this is not fully released yet, currently in a private beta, this application looks really interesting. It's got multiplayer to-do list experience. And you're probably wondering, multiplayer? Okay, I've got that. You probably don't. If you're using something like Todoist, then the application itself is not in real time. Whilst you can see updates from other people pretty much instantaneously, you do not see the cursors of people moving around and actions they actually make. And in Superlist, this is one of the USPs of part of it. And it seems like a really interesting approach to task management. Particularly one of the things that is interesting about Superlist is that the concept itself of task management is about you being able to organize stuff in real time. Maybe you're in a meeting, or maybe you are on in real time organizing stuff and you don't want somebody to add something before you. And that sort of noise and mess can really get in the way. So this might be an interesting solution to that. They also have the ability to create notes, meeting lists, and things like that. And also they have what looks like some pretty neat integrations with Gmail and other such applications, as well as the adding of multimedia as well to take full advantage of the screen real estate. But Superlist, an interesting bet. If anybody's in the private beta, please do reach out to me. But of course, I'm in touch with the Superlist team. So as soon as it does come out, I will obviously cover it then. Next up is routine. And this application, again, is what's being called the most advanced calendar for productive people. And it's available on a few devices now, Mac, Windows, iOS, and web. And the experience is gorgeous. The application allows you to not only plan your today in this lovely timeline-like view, but also allows you to plan your week with your tasks in mind. And I really love the approach to the calendar blocking that they've taken, because it really does help you to realign your tasks, make better use of your time. So for somebody that really likes to use calendar alongside tasks, this is probably going to be one of your best bets. But the application itself still doesn't have a full pricing, although as of this video, they do have one that is coming soon called Professional, which will give you access to additional features that are not available yet. But the core features look like they're part of the free plan, and the Pro plan or Premium plan or Professional plan is starting from $12 per month, which is actually much lower than a lot of the daily planner applications out there. There's other features as well, like Pages, which allows you to take notes, and there's a fantastic feature on Mac, and I believe it's on Windows too, called Console, which allows you to actually save tasks and notes directly into the right locations really instantaneously. And it's one of the best experiences I've seen, because when you open it up, you can not only see the events that are coming up, your next meeting, you could join that if you wanted to, but you can also see much more high level of depth. Next up is Timestripe. Now, Timestripe has been around for a little bit of time, but its application is becoming much more relevant in today's world. With to-do list applications, like a lot of ones we talked about, and many, many more that are on the market, of course, a lot of them are orientated around you organizing your day, week, or month. And that's really it. It's very much in your court to organize that. Timestripe approaches it in a slightly different way, because what it does is it helps you to plan your life. It actually has this view called Horizons, which is the primary view inside of Timestripe, which takes you from day, week, month, and all the way yearly to where you want it to, all the way to your life goals. And what's different about this is we always tend to get lost with to-do list applications because they're very on the ground. Something that David Allen, who wrote Getting Things Done, often refers to as 10,000 feet rule. You're so close to the ground, well, not close, but compared to 50,000 feet, you're closer, and you see stuff in detail. You don't really see the big picture view, and naturally, this application wants to help you do that. It also has some other abilities like boards for being able to see specific lists that you might want to set up. You can also use some of their pre-saved templates and boards that are already part of that, which are actually really helpful to do so. And they've got a function called climbs too, which allows you to copy habits and routines that instantly populate your Timestripe account, which helps you to get going with those. And another thing I really like about it is it's got this beautiful clock view, which allows you to see your life as a perspective of how long you've got to go, or perceived got to go. And it's very daunting, but very sobering. And this is something that I think was really well summarized by Mark Gilroy, who did a fantastic video on YouTube about Timestripe. So if you did want to listen to that one, I'll make sure to include a video about it below. Next up is Akiflow. Again, I talk about Akiflow quite a lot because the application itself is a nice combination between tasks and calendar, much like we see with Routine and Sansama. But the application tends to go a little bit further, and much like Sansama too, it does have the ability to bring in experiences from other applications. So you can bring in Gmail, starred emails that you have, maybe ClickUp, maybe Trello, maybe Notion. It's really up to you what you bring up on. There's quite an advanced amount of integrations. And those integrations mean that you can build a dashboard that you like. So if you and your team are using ClickUp and you don't like ClickUp's view for some reason, or you don't like Trello's view, or you use both of them, you can combine them in Akiflow. And that's quite a different approach to what a lot of productivity applications are doing at the moment, especially in the to-do list application space. And that concept's called consolidation, and it's a really interesting approach to managing your to-do list. So Akiflow has been on my radar for some time, and of course, I believe it's definitely making waves in the productivity space as one that's pushing the boundaries of what we think of as a to-do list application. So I hoped you enjoyed today's feature, folks. If you're looking for any to-do list application, you can find them linked below. We've got a full category on Toolfinder, over 200 tools now, which you could dive into with in-depth reviews and details about them. And also, if you do want to search for one, you can find it using the search bar on the front page. But if you do want to subscribe to this YouTube channel, if you want more of this lovely productivity tool concepts, or you do want to find a perfect tool for you, do subscribe to us. And of course, I'll be happy to help go into deeper into more topics in the near future. So thank you very much. I look forward to seeing you in the future. It was me, Francesco, and I'll see you all very soon, I'm sure. Cheerio.